Hey guys, let's talk about lossless scaling. The app started as a scaling option for gamers who struggle to run their games in native resolutions. It offers multiple scaling algorithms. On January 10th, it introduced its own frame generation solution, becoming the first vendor-agnostic implementation of such tech for games. You can already notice a few interesting facts about it, its perks and quirks. As they are actively developing it and rolling out new updates quite often, please treat this video as a look at the current state of its frame gen solution. There are a few rules that developers and community advise to follow to get the best experience. Personally, I noticed that going above the recommended screen refresh rate is actually helping the algorithm to produce fewer artifacts on my PC. So I set mine to 200 Hz in the first test and just changed the frame rate value. One thing. What do you do when you don't own a proper capture card that is required to record lossless scaling frame gen in war? Well, you go rebel. I simply recorded my screen. I won't be talking much in the video, I just give some comments and point out things I want you to notice in particular. Please observe and draw your own conclusions as well. I encourage you. Okay, we lock our FPS to a half number of the screen refresh rate. I'm using Riva Tuner statistics server feature here. You can see it working. We Alt-tab to lossless scaling or press a shortcut on your keyboard. Then bring the game window to the top. You can notice the FPS counter in the left upper corner of your screen. First thing, for some reason, it doesn't always kick in properly, so let's try again. I entered the recommended 60 FPS this time. Yeah, it's working now. You can notice how the crosshair, a dot in fact, goes crazy here. While the experience is indeed very smooth and works, the algorithm clearly struggles with HUD elements. Let's try 200 FPS again. You can still notice HUD glitches at such frame rate. The map looks nice though. Let's try going below the recommended setting. What if we lock the game to just 30 FPS? Yep, those 60 FPS recommended as the minimum for the best results are justified, definitely. We shouldn't do it, but let's go illegal. 15 frames per second. Well, that's bad. What about 45 FPS? Now my screen is set to a fixed 120 Hz and will stay like that for the rest of the test. Let's move to the next day. In Cyberpunk we can notice an interesting behavior. In certain high contrast situations like this, LSFG manages the crosshair nicely, but struggles again when there are less favorable circumstances. For some reason, there are problems with keeping the intended number of FPS in this game. Cyberpunk is locked to a comfortable 60 FPS at low graphics settings. Again, you can see issues with HUD here. The artifacts are quite apparent in the screen space around the gun too, unfortunately. and when you're driving a car. Another title to test is Red Dead Redemption 2. LSFG works here even with Vulkan API. It looks good, actually. There is some ghosting around Arthur mostly. And again, issues happen on the HUD and around the player. Some problems on the grass at the bottom as well. Let's talk about an elephant in the room. Despite me strictly following official and community recommendations and trying different settings myself, I couldn't manage to get good results. I examined it frame by frame in video editing software, marked the key moments and used some simple calculations to measure the input lag. We know that for a 60fps recording like this, one frame lasts for 16.7 milliseconds. When we count the number of frames that pass since controller activations to the game's reaction, we can get the actual total system input lag. Before you say maybe I somehow staged it, let's come back to Cyberpunk again and try to simply press a button. There is not much that can go wrong there. Alright, total system input lag already looks much better. But LSFG additional input lag turns out to be similar after all. No matter how hard I tried, I kept getting that average 65 milliseconds of additional input lag on my PC. That's a lot. To conclude, I think lossless scaling frame generation is a promising piece of tech. The possibility to use the full potential of a high refresh rate monitor is quite tempting if the rest of your PC can't manage it. Too bad though, it noticeably harasses your experience in fast-paced games given the high input lag. But I hope they manage to make those problems less apparent and try to eliminate artifacts further too. I believe, after all, it's your own decision if you want to test it and can accept those issues given its $7 price tag. Okay folks, that's all for today. Hope this video served you well. See ya!